This video is entitled The Parable of the Wise and Foolish Virgins. Many Christians, if not most Christians, mistakenly, like most parables, think this parable is referring to a split between Christians and non-Christians. Oh no, my friends, that's not where we're at all with this. Okay, first of all, you got your 10 virgins. They're the wedding party. They're the ones who are invited to the wedding. In order to be invited to the wedding feast of Jesus Christ, the marriage supper of the Lamb, you got to be a Christian to start with. Okay? So get that up here. And let's go to step B. All 10 of them are told to be ready because the groom can come at any time. Keep your lamps trimmed and keep a lot of extra oil with you so that when your oil runs out, if he's not back yet, you've got some spare. You've got some extra oil. Okay, so what is the oil? The Holy Spirit is the oil. It's supposed to keep our bodies filled with the Holy Spirit. Keep our heart filled with the Holy Spirit. And how do we do that? First of all, we're saved. When we're saved by the blood of Jesus, the Holy Spirit comes and lives inside of our heart. And next, we pray to be sanctified by the Holy Spirit, to just fill us head to toe, take away evil desires, and cleanse our heart, and make us more and more Christ-like. So in other words, these virgins, half the virgins were totally filled with the Holy Spirit. They had extra oil. They were ready to go. No matter what happened, they had extra Holy Spirit juice and power for those hard times and those times when they had to battle Satan with the Holy Spirit's power, and the times when they had trouble in their lives and hardships and difficulties where the Holy Spirit brought them through. They had the extra power. They had, it's like the energizer. They were plugged into the source. The other virgins, they were saved. They had some Holy Spirit in them. They didn't have a lot. And so when the word came that the groom was coming, and they're scrambling, the wise virgins were ready. They had plenty of oil, trimmed. They were sitting there ready to go, so that when he showed up, all they had to do is just follow him to his father's house and go in to the marriage supper of the Lamb, the wedding feast. The foolish virgins weren't ready. And when it came time, they begged, "Oh, please, give us some of your oil. Give us some of your Holy Spirit." And they said, "Go buy your own, or go get your own Holy Spirit. Pray for it. You should have had your own in your heart to start with. You didn't. So you're not going to get mine. You're not going to take what I need." So the wise virgins went with the groom and the wedding party, and the doors closed. And the foolish virgins were stuck outside, and they couldn't go. So in other words, they didn't go to heaven. These are Christians, okay? And I think that Jesus is using this half and half, using half and half to show us an example. But I believe in today's, in fact, I know if Jesus was to come back right now, that it's more like 95.5%. 95% are not ready to go, 5% are. Because this world is just the great apostasy or falling away from the Lord is everywhere. So that's where we're at right now. So just get this through your heads, first of all, people. Once saved, always saved. Cheap grace. People who treat Joseph Prince like a god with a little g. Get this through your head. Jesus is talking to you and to me. Where there's two in the field, one taken away and one is left. You know, there are two that are preparing food. One's taken away, one's left. He's talking about Christians, okay? Because they're already the ones who are ready to go to the feast. Now, obviously, there's going to be Christians amongst non-Christians. That's going to be a tiny group to start with. We're talking about Christians among Christians. We need to understand exactly what the Lord's trying to tell us in these parables. And I've got other parables that I'm going to break out in videos too, because you need to understand what's going on here. You need to get your head out of the cloud, get away from the cheap grace teaching that you don't have to do anything at all but say a few words, be saved, and then you're good for life. And then again, I know all your tricks. The Holy Spirit's given me vision and word for you guys. And don't try to tell me then that part B is, "Well, Paul, kid, if that person became a backslider and a sinner, they were never really saved to start with." Really? Well, you're calling God a liar in the Holy Bible a book of lies, because my Bible says, Jesus Christ's own words, all who come to me and ask shall be saved. Not some, not most, not 99.9%, all. So they're already saved. And again, I love doing the parable of the sower. I got a video coming out on that. In fact, I may already have it recorded, but I'm going to do one on the fig tree. I think I already may have it recorded. If not, it's coming. But the Holy Spirit's laying these parables on me to break them down and try to shake you. Try to say, hey, wake up and see what's going on. Nap time's over. Sleepy time is over. Okay? It's time to wake up. Pull our heads out of the sand. Stop being ostriches. The ostrich syndrome, I call it. Focus on the prize. Focus on heaven. And don't just set your eyes to heaven. Set your eyes out into the harvest. The harvest is so plentiful, it's rotting in the field because of lack of harvest. And Jesus said, the harvest is plenty. Where are my harvesters at? That's my question too. Where are Jesus' harvesters at? Too many cares in this world bog Christians down. And Christians always try to think that, you know, with the watered down, once saved, always saved, cheap grace, it's horrible. When I was a young boy, a tiny minority of Baptists believed this. And I talked to my wife's aunt, precious woman of God. If they had woman of God in the dictionary, her face would be right there. She's 103 years old. Okay? Just an unbelievable influence. I've talked to her about the old days, and that was tiny in the early 1900s when she was a little girl. So, you know, this people just think they're so smart. The Bible says in the last days that knowledge will greatly increase, and Christians have gotten the big head thinking, well, I know more about the Bible than God. I know what God really meant. God didn't really mean we have to be pure and holy in heaven. He didn't mean that. Jesus did that for everybody, forever. We can just go out and rape and murder and steal and molest little children. We can go worship Satan if we want to. As long as we're saved. We can be gay. What are you talking about? And also, in the last days of the great apostasy, people would just flock to teachers who say what their itching ears want to hear. People like Joseph Prince and just a vast myriad. I always say his name because he's my favorite. He's the one that I've sent letters of rebuke to, and he's the one that's the most dangerous one there is. But it's just time, my friends, to understand, okay? Keep your lamps trimmed with oil. Keep your body filled with the Holy Spirit. So when Jesus Christ comes, the Holy Spirit can convict you when you sin. Because I'm telling you right now, my friends, if you're living for Jesus Christ the way the Bible says, and the Holy Spirit runs your life, if He permeates your entire being, if He's inside your membranes, you can't sin and not feel just an incredible guilt and just say, oh man, Holy Spirit, I'm so sorry. Holy Spirit, thank you for showing me. Forgive me, Lord. I repent of my sins. I repent of it. Forgive me. Restore me anew with you. Wash me with your blood. Make me whole once again. Can't live with yourself. All these false doctrine, phony, cheap grace people, it just makes me sick. It fills me with righteous anger and holy discontent. I say, man, come on, wake up. Wake up. See the truth. Don't die. Go to hell because you weren't ready. The Holy Spirit gave me a vision on the once saved, always saved. I've shared a video on it, but I'll share briefly here because I like to just pound this in. I was praying, Lord, show me something. I was crying, weeping, because I was just trying to open their eyes. Immediately, He took me in the air outside the pearly gates of heaven. Tens of millions of people in hell screaming, faceless, like you see. You paste a face on a thing, they're just white, round things, screaming, let us in, angel. We're in hell. We're Christians. We don't belong here. And the angel said, God's servants came to you over and over and over and over again and showed you the truth from the Holy Bible. You refuse to believe, and you're where you're going to be forever. You are in hell because you were told the truth, and you wouldn't believe it. And then, like a dozen or so, they actually had faces. It was the same people on Facebook that I've been doing battle with. The Holy Spirit even showed me their faces, and I let them know this. They called me a liar, a heretic, a false prophet, the devil. They called God these names. God sent me with a vision, so they called God those names. Woe, woe, woe unto you, my friends. Don't even try. You're in some serious trouble for doing that. But they wouldn't even believe. I had to shake dust from my feet and move on because they are just pure blasphemers and heretics saying that kind of stuff about God and the Bible and about a vision that a servant of the Lord gave them to try to save them from hell. Google this name, Dan, Dan, Corner, Corner. and then put OSAS next to it. Click. It'll pull up the best resource in the world that 100% refutes Once Saved, Always Saved. It has hundreds of scripture. Not little twisted scripture or this piece missing or that part shifted around like the Once Saved, Always Saved do. Oh, no. Full scripture. This guy's got it covered on this page. He's got all kinds of little activities. Zero. Zero doubt that Once Saved, Always Saved is a lie from hell. If you go through this link and read all that scripture and still are so poisoned by Joseph Prince and his ilk, then Satan's got you, my friends, and you already made reservations at the Hellfire Inn forever, and the 666 Express is on its way to take you down there, and the bellboy will check you in. That's the bottom line. So, understand what the parable of the 10 virgins is all about. It's about you and me, Christians, having your lamps filled, your bodies filled with the Holy Spirit, ready at all times, living right, repenting when you sin, staying close to God. No sin is going to enter heaven, my friends. Known unrepentant sin will not enter heaven. The Bible says it. He means what he says. Let's pray. Heavenly Father, please help Christians to wake up, to know the truth from your word. You wrote the Holy Bible so clear to see, Heavenly Father. If we use Holy Spirit vision, we'll see it every time. Help people to wake up, to see the truth, to understand. Shine a light on things for us. Remove blinders and scales from eyes. Help everyone to see what the truth of your word is and to understand that it's a small number of Christians that are ready right now to go to heaven. We need a huge revival. We need people to fall on their knees and repent from being backslidden, living in iniquities, which is unrepentant sin, and do it now. Because time's running out. You're going to come in the twinkling of an eye. That fast. No time to repent. No time for time out. No time for a do-over. You're ready or you're not. Help us be ready, Jesus. Pierce hearts. Tug on hearts. Convict hearts. Rebuke, correct, teach. Show us the light. Precious name I ask it. Amen. As always, my friends, if you are watching this video and don't know Jesus Christ as Lord and Savior, pray this prayer with me. Say, Jesus, I know that I've sinned in my life. I've done bad things and I'm sorry. I believe you came to earth. I believe you died on the cross for my sins. I believe on the third day you're risen again, back to the right hand of the Father. And since that time, you've been preparing a place in heaven for all Christians forever. Please forgive me my sins, Jesus. Come live in my heart. Cleanse me. Make me a new creature in Christ, a child of the King. In the precious name I ask it. Amen. Jesus says in his own words in the Holy Bible that all who come to me and ask shall be saved. If you'd like me to pray with you, send me an inbox or personal message. You can call me. I'd love to pray with you for salvation. It's my honor. Privilege. If you have a friend, neighbor, or loved one who don't know Jesus Christ as Lord and Savior, if you have a sick friend, relative, neighbor, a sick co-worker, a sick pet, if you need a job, car, home, food, clothing, water, whatever you need, send me an inbox or private message. I'd love to pray with you. I have the gift of faith. I prayed for and received gift of faith. I have mustard seed faith, my friends. I pray believing 100% in my heart, speaking out loud 100% with my voice, knowing God will answer all my prayers, everyone, as long as I pray within his holy will. The same for you, my friends. Test him. His word never returns empty. Thanks so much for watching this video. I appreciate it, but share it. Share the link to my page, the link to individual videos you like. Use it as a witnessing tool for friends, neighbors, loved ones, coworkers, strangers. Drop it in blogs somewhere online. We have to get the Word of God out, the uncut, pure Word of God. Never for our glory, never for my glory. All glory is always reflected back to Jesus Christ from me. I love you guys so much. I pray for you all the time, and I pray that God would bless you and keep you on the path or bring you to the right path if you're not there. Thanks.